This video will describe how we assess chromatin heterogeneity and summarize our validations of the marker. The marker was developed by training machine learning algorithms using a cohort of 390 patients treated at Aker University Hospital in Norway. These patients had stage 1 and 2 colorectal cancer and were resected between 1993 and 2003. Each cancer was labeled according to its severity, using extensive follow-up data. To correlate this labeling of patient prognosis with observations of chromatin organization in the tumor cell nuclei, we first computed a matrix which stores information about chromatin organization. The procedure for doing so begins by isolating cell nuclei from the tumor sample of a patient. These nuclei are stained to reveal DNA density. On average, 1,200 nuclei of each tumor sample are imaged and normalized to obtain resilience to vagaries in the measurement process. They are subsequently sorted into groups according to nuclear area, which is calculated as the nuclear pixel count. The texture of each nucleus is analyzed by computing a matrix which combines gray level and entropy. This matrix is initialized as the zero matrix. A square window is centered at the leftmost pixel on the first row. In this instance, the window size is 3x3. The pixels in the window are extracted and their gray level entropy computed. This entropy and the gray level of the center pixel in the window specifies an element in the gray level entropy matrix, and the value of this element is incremented. This concludes the first iteration. The same computation is performed for each pixel in the nuclear image. When each pixel has been processed, the matrix provides information about how frequently each pair of entropy and center gray level occurs in the given nuclear image. The matrix stores information about higher order chromatin structure, DNA density, and the relation between these two quantities. The gray level entropy matrix is computed for every nucleus acquired from the tumor sample. In each area group, the set of gray level entropy matrices are summed, and the sum is divided by the total number of analyzed nuclei. This completes the computation for the 3x3 window. To analyze at multiple scales, we also compute the matrices for windows of size 5x5. And every odd number up to 31x31 pixels. This set of matrices is referred to as the four-dimensional gray-level entropy matrix of the tumor sample. For this animation, we will abbreviate the matrix and refer to it as GLEM-4D. In the discovery phase, we learn how texture patterns correlate with patient prognosis. This phase begins by sorting the cohort of 390 patients according to their prognosis. The GLEM-4D is then computed for each patient. Each element of the GLEM-4D is treated independently, and the frequency of each element value in patients with good prognosis is calculated and plotted as a histogram. The same computations are performed for patients with poor prognosis. We then compute the statistical discrepancy between the prognosis groups as the difference in means divided by the standard deviation. This estimate is then stored in the corresponding element of a matrix, which has a size identical to the GLEM-4D. This process is iterated over every element of the GLEM-4D, resulting in a four-dimensional weight matrix. The 4D weight matrix is combined with the GLEM-4D of each patient by multiplying the values of corresponding elements. The sum of these products is the chromatin value, which is then plotted in a histogram. The process is repeated for each patient with good prognosis, which yields a distribution of chromatin values for good prognosis patients. The same operation is performed for patients with poor prognosis. The mean chromatin value of patients with good prognosis is compared to the mean of poor prognosis patients, and the average of the means is defined as the threshold that distinguishes between chromatin heterogeneous and chromatin homogeneous tumor samples. To assess the chromatin heterogeneity of a new patient, we need the 4D weight matrix and the threshold which was computed in the discovery phase. The tumor nuclei of the patient undergo the same preparation and imaging procedure as described earlier, and the GLEM-4D is calculated. We can now apply the 4D weight matrix by multiplying it with the GLEM-4D, and the sum of the elements yields the chromatin value. The chromatin heterogeneity of the patient is determined by comparing the chromatin value to the threshold. This marker of chromatin heterogeneity is termed nucleotyping. To evaluate the prognostic value of chromatin heterogeneity, we validated nucleotyping in two independent cohorts of patients with colorectal cancer, which were mainly from the UK, as well as two cohorts of patients with gynecological carcinoma, a cohort of patients with uterine sarcoma, and a cohort of patients with prostate cancer. The stage 2 colorectal cancer patients in the discovery cohort had a 5-year cancer-specific survival of 83% if chromatin homogeneous, and 72% if chromatin heterogeneous. Similar survival rates were observed for stage 2 patients in the Gloucester validation cohort. In the Quasar 2 validation cohort, where all patients received adjuvant chemotherapy, the 5-year cancer-specific survival was 94% if chromatin homogeneous and 88% if chromatin heterogeneous. However, the hazard ratio of 2.2 is similar as in the two other colorectal cancer cohorts. Microsatellite instability is often used in clinical practice to identify a subgroup of stage 2 colorectal cancer patients where adjuvant treatment can be omitted. Chromatin heterogeneity was a significant predictor of cancer-specific survival in microsatellite unstable and microsatellite stable stage 2 tumors. However, microsatellite instability did not supplement chromatin heterogeneity. Selecting low-risk patients by nucleotyping could therefore perhaps identify substantially more stage 2 colorectal cancer patients with presumably small absolute benefit of adjuvant chemotherapy. Nucleotyping predicted cancer-specific survival also in the analysis of ovarian cancer, endometrial cancer, uterine sarcoma, and prostate cancer. In all cohorts except the prostate cancer cohort, chromatin heterogeneity was significant in multivariable analysis with established prognostic markers. This altogether indicates that chromatin heterogeneity is a pan-cancer independent prognostic tumor characteristic. Nucleotyping can provide robust measurement of chromatin heterogeneity and may potentially improve selection of treatment in a wide range of clinical settings. For more information, please read our publication in The Lancet Oncology.